regardless of your heritage, in today's video, Sam is going to show you how to dance with your little jig. What's up, guys? Sam here. Welcome back to Samcraft. And yes, that's right. Today's video is about laser jigs, specifically the ones that I make, manufacture, and sell for the xTool F1 Ultra, as well as other machines. But today's focus is on the F1 Ultra jig, how to use them, how to focus your jigs and your objects to engrave, what exactly all the holes in it are for, and most importantly, how to use the template file, project files, and everything else you get when you buy one from me. So as of the making of this video, I have a pretty good selection of F1 Ultra jigs, but I am literally creating and making new ones almost every single day. So what I will show you today, and I'll put down here on the screen, is my current offerings as of July 20th, 2024. But definitely go check out my website to see the current offerings and the machines. Maybe this one has been replaced with something else. You've got other machines, go check it out on my website. My goal is to make printed jigs, 3D printed jigs, for as many different laser models out there. For anyone who, like me, has a laser engraving business and wants to make their production faster, easier, and less of a headache, my goal is to provide solutions to you so you can be faster and basically make more money, right? Less labor, same amount of sales price, more money in your pocket. For those following my channel real time, you will now also realize, whoa, wait a second. Sam, you got an F1 Ultra. You've not released a video on it yet. No, I've not. I don't like to make videos on lasers, machines, or anything until I've had them and I've used them and I just know them more than what I find out when I open a box. So, sneak peek, yep, it's in the shop. Sam's tested it, Sam's vetting it, but in this video, I am going to share some info for people who have my jigs. All right, first up is gonna be one of my most popular sellers. This is a drink coaster jig designed to hold 4 circle or 4 square drink coasters. I'm gonna load this over on the machine. First thing I want to show is how to focus and then answer the question, what are all the holes for? Okay, let's answer the easy thing first, and that is, what are the holes for? Which ones should I use and why are there so many? So all of my jigs are designed and scaled so that you are able to reuse the thumb screws that you receive with your machine, this xTool F1 Ultra, with the little corner jig. You unthread those, and you've got 2 of these guys right here that you're able to use with my jigs. I also include stainless steel hardware so that you have additional bolts, especially for some extra holes. So ultimately, you've got 4 options: top, right, left, bottom, or in the case of this drink coaster jig, top center, bottom center, left, and right. The whole layout will change based upon the jig and how it fits on your laser. In addition to the perimeter holes, you've got 2 in the center. The reason the 2 in the center are there is that these jigs are plastic. They're made from PLA. They are strong, they are fairly rigid, but over time, I knew that they would be subjected to stresses and forces. I also knew that there was a possibility they may not always lay perfectly flat on your laser. Given lasers have a certain amount of focal distance, having a flat jig is very important. So the extra holes in the middle are for you to use if you need. Add those extra bolts that you get in my kits and really clamp this guy down. You have perimeters and you have center. This will allow you, for whatever reason, if things get wonky, like, again, I don't think they will, but if they do, I give you the hardware and the ability to lock it down dead set so you don't have issues with engraving due to, honestly, variable heights for focus. All right, guys, so first off, in case you don't know how to focus the F1 Ultra, it's done with this keypad that comes with the machine. You press the up arrow to raise the laser, the down arrow to lower it, and what you want are your red and blue dots to be right on top of each other and basically become one dot on top of the surface you intend to engrave. So right here, if I hold down the up arrow, you're able to see how the dots move apart. And as I hold the down arrow, they get closer until right there, right on top of each other. That means the laser is now focused to the surface of the bed. That doesn't really help us out as far as it goes with jigs, because right now it's focused on the bed, not on the jig, or even more so, on the item we really want to engrave. So what I would suggest to do is exactly what I just did. Take your jig, put it on the bed, leave it floating, put one of your objects in the jig, and now we can see the dots, and using the keypad, I can raise it up right there. Now the dots are one, and I know my laser is now focused to the top of this jig. That's good. So now I will go ahead and orient the jig however I want. Use my thumb screws here to lock it down. And then fill out the jig with the rest of my items to engrave. I lost a coaster. Okay, just three for this example. So at this point, the jig is set, the focus is set, you should not have to change it. The same kind of concept will apply to square coasters, since this is a two-in-one jig. However, now that we have squares, we're at a different height. I'm going to loosen this back thumb screw and loosen the front. And then if I can just pivot it enough to where it's there on the surface, I can just raise it, lower it, refocus, and then pivot it back over, put the thumb screw in, referencing the holes in the bed, and then we're good to go. Obviously, a perfect world scenario would be if all the jigs had the objects in the middle, so you don't have to move it around, but that's just not the way it panned out when dealing with all of the irregular and various thickness objects that I've made jigs for. So this is Sam's recommendation. Pivot it over, adjust it, put it back. Looking specifically at my pen jig, so this is designed to hold 15 pens for engraving, and it is also designed to hold them in a various different layouts. Let me grab some pens real quick. Okay, so this jig is to allow you to orient it this way. You can also rotate the little pocket clip that way, and if you want to do the back, it will recess down, straight down, face down into the jig. So this is why I call it the universal pen jig. It'll allow you to fit multiple different sizes in different orientations. So in this example, I've got some pins here. My jig is still floating. My recommendation, move it over to where the pin is right below your lasers. Raise it up right there. Now we are in focus with the top of the pins. I can move it over and I can lock it in however we want. This particular jig is one of my thicker jigs. I think it is about 11 millimeters thick. I had to make it that thick so that it would allow the pocket clips to recess down deep into the jig. So in this case, the thumb screws you get with your machine won't really fit. I mean, it's close, so I don't consider these to work with this jig, but that's okay. That's why I give you four of these stainless steel hex head socket screws, or whatever they're called, the bolts. And so for these, you can choose if you want to put them in the middle. Just kind of wiggle it around, feel for that hole, that threaded base. You can do it there. Honestly, this is where I do put my bolts for this jig. I only put the two in the middle. That holds it square, it holds it flat if there's any movement like I mentioned earlier, and it's minimal hardware to use. You don't have to crank these down. In fact, I would not advise you to crank them down because this is plastic, you could damage it. And also, if it's sitting flat on your bed, there's really no need. It's there, it's fine. You just don't want to bump it and you're good to go. Changing it out is fairly easy, especially if you want to change the orientation, which all of my jigs do have the symmetrical design so that they can be oriented either way in your machine. I have worked very hard to make sure they are perfect squares laid out and centered with the working area of the machines I sell them for. So if you, for some reason, want to change your pin direction to that, have at it. There's no problem at all. You can do whatever you want with this one and my other jigs as well. All right, guys, for this segment, I'm going to be using my business card jig, which all my jigs are two color 3D prints and the information is on the back. This is one of the most popular jigs that I'm selling right now, and I totally understand why. Metal engraved business cards are very popular. So I'm going to lock it in here with a thumb screw, and I'll do my other one right there just because it's easy to reach. I'm leaving this loose on purpose. Oh, did you guys see what I just forgot to do? I forgot to focus, so let me pull it over. I got a business card in there. There we go. Now we're focused, and we'll lock it back into place loosely. Go ahead and fill out the jig, add the rest of the cards here. And we are ready to open xTool Creative Space on the computer, and I'll walk you through the process of aligning, double checking the layout of the template, and then how to use it. All right guys, I've got screen recording going on. You're seeing my computer screen. I have xTool Creative Space opened up, and I have my business card jig template file opened as well. So I've gone around on a couple of iterations on, okay, do I send you the file completely locked down and centered and think you're going to be good enough there? Or do I teach you how to fish and teach you how to take the regular graphics, move them around, align them with your jig, and really lock things in for your particular laser? Even though we may have the same model, they may not be lined up exactly the same. And the way xTool Creative Space is currently programmed, there is no dead set center point. I can't tell this to go to the center of the canvas. Check this out on the screen, you'll see what I mean. So I'm grabbing everything, I'm moving it around. You see how we have crosshairs right here? But look, as I kind of twitch and jiggle it, it's telling me, yeah, you're centered, but it's still moving around. And I can leave it. It doesn't snap to the dead center. That, from a template jig aspect, is a nightmare. So, I'm gonna teach you guys how to fish. You're gonna get a file, you're gonna open it up, landscape or portrait. I have my landscape file open. Over here at the top left is where you see landscape. Click on that. This is where the canvas section of xTool Creative Space lives. So from here, I could click on the portrait, twist my jig, good to go. Click on landscape, same thing, good to go. I will include separate files just so, I don't know everyone's level of experience with the software, so I want to make it as approachable and beneficial to anyone, regardless of your usability experience or just in general. So, okay, landscape, here we go. If you look right now, as I hover, all of them highlight. These shapes are grouped. I do that so you can align it with your jig the easiest. So go ahead and click it, or select, drag, whatever you need. Highlight all of it. Go ahead and at the top right, click on output. That way when we frame the machine or tell it to frame, it will actually do that. Let's go down here to framing at the bottom right, click on the three lines. Let's change it from rectangle to outline. And then I like to increase that framing power just because it's easier for me to see. Do what you want with that one. At this point, what I will do is try and put this dead center as best I can, leaving it highlighted. Now I'm going to click on framing. We give it a second, we look at the laser, and now it is framing. Let me record that real quick with my phone. That way I don't lose, honestly, the audio sync with the computer. It's going to be hard to see on camera, but the laser is framing out six individual rectangles. What you want to do next is move this, if need be, or with the file shapes selected here, with your arrow keys up, down, left, right, move it until it's where you want. What I would recommend doing, take your file here, drop it dead center. Let's go over here and check the card. Honestly, it's really close, so I'm going to go ahead and lock down my thumb screws. And honestly, that looks good to me. It's going to depend upon your level of perfectionism, perhaps your design, on how much time you want to spend. But what I would suggest to do at this point, with the jig tightened down, select the graphic like we have it here, and use your arrow keys up, down, left, right to walk it in if you want to. Once you're happy with that, we're now going to lock this down because we have aligned it with our machine. So I'm going to click on stop framing. I'm going to click here to select the graphics again. I will click on ungroup because now what I want to see as I move my mouse, I want each individual business card to highlight on its own. I'll tell you why here in a second. And now what I will do is click drag, select everything, unclick output, right click on it, and choose lock slash unlock. Whenever I click that, these are now locked. This is a feature that was missing from xTool Creative Space for a while. It's here with XCS 2.0. So now at this point, this is my template. I want to go to File, Save As, and save it as a new one, because what you get from Sam is a DIY file. It's not locked down. It's not calibrated to your machine. Once you've done this, save your work. But my advice would be don't overwrite the original file. If you do, hit me up. You'll get another one. All right, at this point, I want to show you how, if we do some text, we'll be so original. We're going to engrave a business card that says Sam. The reason I ungrouped the rectangles before I locked them down is because now the crosshairs will snap to each individual shape. If I didn't ungroup them, it would not give me crosshairs on this business card here, or there, or over there. So that's the importance of ungrouping. At this point, you are ready to use your machine as normal. You know, set your parameters, whatever you've tested, you're good to go, and that's how you use the jig. In the interest of keeping this as short as possible and concise, that is going to be all I want to cover in this one video. If you have questions, if you're a customer of mine, shoot me an email. There's an email on that card you get in your package. Hit me up. I'm here to help you. I don't just sell you a product, throw a file at you, and tell you good luck. The reason that I feel like I can sell products is because you're getting Sam's support behind it. So take advantage of it however you need. So that's going to cover this part of the video. If you got questions or comments, you know what to do. Leave me down below. Otherwise, thanks for watching. As always, take care. I'll see you guys next time in the workshop.